I got into silhouette cutting by answering a blind ad in the newspaper that just said art company looking for sales help at local theme park. So I've been working in, on, and around theme park property since about 1989. I was already an artist, but had never cut a silhouette before. Silhouette cutting comes from France. The French Minister of Finance was named Étienne de Silhouette, and he worked under King Louis XV. Silhouettes crossed all boundaries of class, from royalty all the way down to cottage dwellers. As only the extremely wealthy could afford to have an oil painting commission, this was a really nice and affordable way of having a portrait done to keep family records. And having your silhouette made only cost about a penny a piece back then. Most of the silhouette artists were itinerant. They traveled the countryside on horseback and went from village to village where they were welcomed with opened arms. They would then make silhouette shades of every person in town. The really nice thing about what I do is that it's very self-sufficient. I'm self-contained. All I need is just a bit of ambient light, a small table, and two chairs of the same height. I'm actually drawing with scissors, so the advantage of doing straight cutting is that it's so fast. It takes only about 90 seconds to do a portrait, which roughly translates into about 100 portraits in 4 hours. It's also a very child-friendly art form because most children don't want to sit still for very long. Silhouettes are a unique and quick way to capture their image. I like the charm of silhouettes. I like that there's something old-fashioned in this age of digital photography and technology. It's nice having something that's a throwback to an art form that predates photography by 100 years. What's nice for the guest that receives a silhouette portrait is that it's very different, very unusual. Most people have never even seen it done, so the act of watching me cut a silhouette out is a show in itself. It's just like they're taking home a little piece of history.